That man's an imposter. That man is the imposter.
This photo perfectly demonstrates the typical operating mode of new processor while overclocked. Welcome to BenchLand, I won't waste your time and I'll just arrange a short 5-minute session, cause there is really nothing special to talk about. Rig characteristics are on screen now. We still have same Raptor Lake architecture, same stepping 1, revision B0, we have some boosted frequencies, unlocked 3rd E-core cluster, plus a little processor cache. And that's all! The new CPU is ready! 14 is more than 13! And similar bullshit marketing. Let's start with IGP. All the same Intel UHD graphics 770, which is not able to provide even a satisfactory game console frame rate. And now it is inferior in terms of technology compared to AM5 platform. Overclocking potential. Chiller can't handle it. 5.8 GHz on all cores with 1.45 volts on CPU. E-cores, like Encore, are fixed at frequency of 4.5 GHz. The potential of other CPUs are now on screen. During overclocking, no gateway to hell was opened, but 0.5 kW of load successfully utilized through EPS 12V connectors. Fortunately, on standard stock settings it's an average of 285 watts. Let's move on to benchmark performance. Don't forget to look at 8P mode with pure 8 cores. There is certainly growth in synthetic loads, especially for tasks scalable on physical cores. Here, as expected, the processor performs very well. Unfortunately, not all participants were tested right now, so there are gaps in new disciplines. There are also benches that are not supported by developers and do not scale well on E-cores, for example X265 benchmark, where CPUs performed only in 8P mode. Now let's have a look at gaming performance. I decided to start with Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 for a reason. Current heavyweight games in most cases will be limited by your GPU, not the CPU. For example, now on screen you simply cannot see the difference between overclocking and factory defaults in real time. But the telemetry itself caught and noted performance statistics. The situation is similar with other games in 1080p resolution. Moreover, games capable of rendering high refresh rate can be wobble and annoying. Take a look at Wreckfest at 1000 FPS level. Usual picture tearing, whatever, but it will infuriate you so much on this frame rate. And now a brief summary of other gaming disciplines. And of course, let's make fast head-to-head with other CPUs. Apparently, Intel is planning a new processor strategy. Arrow Lake refresh is already scheduled, and today's Raptor Lake refresh is the first iteration of this strategy and analysis of market behavior. If market likes it, we will probably have 2 CPU generations and 2 CPU refreshes per socket. But don't get it wrong. If we forget about existence of 13th gen and potential discounts, we have an ultimate processor of 2023 before us. Even the overclocked Intel Core i9-10980XE will not be able to catch up with it, having 18 full-fledged cores on chip, which cost $979 in 2019. However, user can be humiliated by benchmarks. If you carefully studied the graphs, you notice that in 8P operating mode the difference between past gen flagships is pretty noticeable. Skylake++, aka Intel Core i9-9900K, as well as desktopped laptop Tiger, Intel Core i9-11900K, were left behind. Therefore, it is an excellent CPU for all occasions, but only if you are ready to spend some time for tweaking and already have an effective cooler solution. And if you turn E-cores back... And that's it! Thanks for watching! Subscribe, like and share this video with others! Until next time in BenchLand!